Good morning. Today we are going to deal with the topic of chemistry of alkaloids. So as usual, one must begin with basic questions related to alkaloids. So what are alkaloids? Where they occur, how they are isolated, what are their general properties? These questions we must have to begin with. As per the syllabus, we are expected to learn the introduction, that is concept of alkaloids, occurrence, isolation, classification, properties, general methods, general properties, general methods for structural determination, and analytical evidences and synthesis of one particular alkaloid, that is nicotine. So the first question, what are alkaloids? Alkaloids are a class of basic naturally occurring organic compounds that contain at least one nitrogen atom. So the thing is, alkaloids are naturally occurring, these are basic in nature, and the basic nature is due to presence of nitrogen atom, at least one nitrogen atom. Okay. So this group includes some related compounds with natural and even weakly acidic properties. Some exceptional compounds are there. Some synthetic compounds of similar structure are also considered as alkaloids. So what are alkaloids? We have seen. What is the general appearance? Alkaloids are generally colorless, crystalline and non-volatile liquids and are bitter in taste. Alkaloids are generally insoluble in water but soluble in alcohol, ether and chloroform, that is insoluble in aqueous medium and soluble in organic medium. Many of the alkaloids are important drugs. Alkaloids are quite important drugs. Alkaloids are very important compounds for human being. For ages, their extracts were used as a cure to rescue people from pain, like morphine. Morphine was the example, and some illnesses like by using quinine like alkaloids in malaria and colchicine in gout. So in earlier period, these alkaloids were used as drugs. Even today, some of the alkaloids are used in the treatments also. Okay. Alkaloids are a group of molecules with a relatively large occurrence in nature around the globe. They occur diversely. They are very diverse chemicals and biomolecules, but they are all secondary compounds and are derived from amino acids or by the transamination or by transamination process. Alkaloids also occur in animal kingdom. Then alkaloids are produced by a large variety of organisms, including bacteria, fungi, plants and animals. They can be purified from crude extracts of these organisms by acid base extraction or solvent extraction followed by silica gel column chromatography. To isolate alkaloids from plants, the dried and powdered plant material is extracted. It is extracted with petroleum ether, PET ether or hexane or other suitable solvents. The material can also be separated by alcohol extraction, for example methanol or ethanol. The extract is evaporated to leave the crude alkaloid mixture. So these are the sources and the examples of alkaloids which exist in these natural resources. Just go through this slide. It is not expected to write in the examination. You will find that several naturally occurring alkaloids are there and which are of quite importance. Generally, based on how they are classified, generally based on the structure, alkaloids can be divided into classes like indoles, quinolines, isoquinolines, pyrrolidines, pyridines, pyrrolizidines, tropoens, then terpenoids and steroids. Other classification system is connected with a family of plant species in which they occur. So this is a general chart indicating the classification. pyrrolidine, it contains parent ring pyrrole, and hygrine is the example. So, in this way the examples are given in this slide. Similar examples are also there, these are the common things. And the ring structure they contain and name of the alkaloid is given. Just go through these things only for information. Now, the important part is general methods of structural determination. So, in general, these are the methods used to investigate, used to confirm, used to estimate various functional forms, functional groups present in alkaloids. So, we are going to deal this concept in two parts. Today, we are going to deal with some of the methods. Number one, alkaloids contain oxygen. Essentially, they contain nitrogen, but additionally, they may contain oxygen. So, the oxygen will have different functional forms. Let us consider some of these forms and how they are detected or estimated. Oxygen is present in the form of hydroxy group. If it is present in the form of hydroxy group, then the presence of hydroxy group in an alkaloid is indicated by acetylation or benzoylation reaction. The idea is a very simple basic idea. If you have alcoholic group, then alcoholic group can be acetylated to corresponding acetyl derivative by using acetic anhydride. So, alcoholic group OH on acetylation give corresponding acetyl derivative and the byproduct is acetic acid. Okay. Then next, the same reaction can be carried out by using acetyl chloride. Instead of acetic anhydride, you can use acetyl chloride CH3COCl. The reaction is same again, we get acetyl derivative, only the difference is in byproduct. In earlier case, when it is acetic anhydride, we get acetic acid as the byproduct, and when it is acetyl chloride, we get HCl as the byproduct. Then similarly, you can benzoylate. For benzoylation purpose, we use benzoyl chloride as the reagent, and benzoylation reaction gives corresponding benzoyl derivative. So, the question is, presence of hydroxy group in an alkaloid is investigated, is detected by acetylation or benzoylation reaction. If benzoyl derivative or acetyl derivative is formed, then it is having OH group. Then by investigating the number of acetic anhydride, number of acetyl chloride or number of benzoyl chloride molecules, you can estimate the number of OH groups also. Okay. Suppose if the compound contains phenolic OH group, then the phenolic presence of phenolic OH group is confirmed by reaction between the compound and thionyl chloride. So, this halide is formed with the corresponding aromatic system with the elimination of SO2 and HCl. So, presence of phenolic OH is investigated by reaction between the alkaloid and thionyl chloride. Okay. Then, once the compound contains alcoholic group, you have to investigate whether it is primary, secondary, tertiary, etc. So, this is carried out by very simple procedure. If your compound contains primary alcohol, then on oxidation, initially it gets converted into aldehyde. Any primary alcohol, when it is oxidized, it undergoes oxidation and gives an aldehyde, and the aldehyde is further oxidized to acid. So, alcohol to aldehyde, aldehyde to acid, and during this entire process, number of carbons remain same. If the alkaloid undergoes oxidation giving aldehyde and finally acid with the same number of carbons, then definitely it is having primary alcohol. In case of secondary alcohol, there is a difference. Secondary alcohol also undergoes oxidation, but now the oxidation product is not aldehyde but ketone. With secondary alcohol, it undergoes oxidation to ketone and then subsequently into acid, but the acid is formed as a result of the fragmentation, and therefore the ketone will have same number of carbons, but the acid will have less number of carbons. If the acid is having same carbons, then it is primary alcohol. If the acid is having less number of carbons, then it is ketonic group. Okay. Then, if the secondary alcoholic group is present in ring system. Suppose this is cyclohexanol, then it is converted into ketone as usual with the same number of carbons, and again it is converted into dicarboxylic acid. This dicarboxylic acid has same number of carbons like the original ring. If the acid is having same number of carbons and if it is dicarboxylic, then the OH group, that is alcoholic group, is present in the ring system. Then presence of alkoxy group. Alkoxy group presence can be detected and estimated by Zeisel's method. What is Zeisel's method? In Zeisel's method, the alkoxy compound, that is in this case methoxy compound, is boiled with hydroiodic acid at 399 Kelvin and we get methyl iodide. See carefully. This method is useful for detection as well as estimation. When quantitatively carried out, it becomes estimation. So, the methoxy compound, that is alkoxy compound, when it is boiled with hydroiodic acid, gives a product methyl iodide. Okay. This methyl iodide formed is absorbed in silver nitrate, calculated amount of course, and this silver nitrate in alcoholic condition converts that methyl iodide into silver iodide, and this silver iodide can be weighed and estimated. So, 1 mole of methoxy group gives 1 mole of silver iodide. By using this stoichiometric relation, you can calculate the presence of number of methoxy group in the compound. So, the question will be, methoxy or alkoxy groups can be detected or estimated by Zeisel's method. In Zeisel's method, we use hydroiodic acid as the reagent, and methyl iodide form is absorbed, or it is allowed to react with silver nitrate to get silver iodide, and from the amount of silver iodide you can calculate amount of methoxy group or methoxy compound. Okay. Then carbonyl group. Carbonyl groups are commonly aldehydic or ketonic. So, initially you have to investigate whether carbonyl group is present or not. So, the presence of carbonyl group, carbonyl functional group, is initially detected by several reagents like hydroxylamine, phenylhydrazine, etc. So, in this case, the compound reacts with hydroxylamine forming an oxime. If it is oxime of aldehyde, then it will be aldoxime. If it is oxime of ketone, then it will be ketoxime. So, by using quantitatively, you can investigate, you can estimate the amount of carbonyl group. That is, 1 mole of aldehydic or ketonic group gives 1 mole of hydroxylamine, consumes 1 mole of hydroxylamine, and you get corresponding oxime. So, by considering this stoichiometry, 1 carbonyl group consumes 1 hydroxylamine. So, you can confirm the presence of presence and amount of carbonyl group. Now, the carbonyl groups present in the compound is to be differentiated. As I mentioned earlier, carbonyl groups are of two types. One is aldehydic carbonyl, other is ketocarbonyl. If the carbonyl is aldehydic, then on reduction it gives primary alcohol. If the carbonyl group is aldehydic, then it gives primary alcohol, and if it is ketonic, then it gives secondary alcohol. So, formation of primary alcohol by reduction by using sodium ethanol, if it is giving primary alcohol, then it is aldehyde. If it is giving secondary alcohol, then it is ketonic in nature. Then presence of methylene dioxyl group, that is OCH2O group. If such group is present, then it forms an intermediate dihydroxy compound, and this dihydroxy compound is converted into formaldehyde, and it is converted into formic acid at the end. So, by estimating the amount of formic acid formed, you can investigate presence of and number of methylene dioxyl group. So, the reaction is reaction with HCl, boiling with HCl, it gives an intermediate dihydroxy compound, it gets converted into formaldehyde, and formaldehyde into formic acid. So from number of molecules of formic acid you can get the idea. Then presence of carboxyl group. The carboxyl group is very easily detected, and what is the procedure? Solubility in sodium carbonate or bicarbonate or sodium hydroxide. If it is sodium carbonate or sodium bicarbonate, then it will give CO2 as the byproduct. So solubility in sodium carbonate or sodium bicarbonate with efflorescence indicate presence of carboxyl group. So this is a general reaction which we have studied several times. Then again, if it is having carboxylic acid group, then it is confirmed by esterification, because acids and alcohol undergo esterification, and this reaction confirms the presence of acidic group. Alcohol and acid, or acid and alcohol, they undergo esterification. Formation of ester is an important property of acids, and this will lead you presence of carboxyl group. For estimation of carboxyl group, you can titrate the solution of acid with standard alkali, and the result will give you the amount percentage of COH group. That is, 1 mole of acid corresponds to 1 mole of NaOH. By using this stoichiometric relation, you can calculate the amount of COH group present in the compound. Then if the compound contains ester, initially we have seen that if it is containing acid, then acid with alcohol gives ester. But if it has ester, then reverse reaction can be carried out. Ester is hydrolyzed by using acid hydrolysis, and this on hydrolysis give an acid and an alcohol. So RCOOH and R-OH. So hydrolysis, if it is giving acid and alcohol, then it is ester, and condensation with alcohol, if it is giving ester, then it is having acid. So this difference is there. Then there are several miscellaneous groups, general functional groups in the compound. These are possibilities. If it contains an amide group RCONH2, then this on alkaline hydrolysis give acid and ammonia. See carefully. If it has amide, then amide is converted into acid, and what is evolved is ammonia. Okay, ammonia is evolved. If it is having lactone, this is OCO is the lactone portion. If it is having lactone structure, lactone ring, then this on hydrolysis gives hydroxy acid. One, this O is converted into OH group, so it is hydroxy acid. One, oxygen is converted into OH, and CO portion is converted into acidic portion. So it is hydroxy acid. If the compound is having lactam, that is NHCOCO portion, then this on hydrolysis gives amino acid NH2 and COO. Yes, so it must be O. So we get amino acid. In this way, miscellaneous groups like amide, lactone, lactam can be investigated by hydrolysis reaction. Then in the beginning, we have seen that alkalides must contain amino group. That is, it is the essential part, nitrogen atom. It is essentially there. If the compound contains primary amine, then the primary amine when react with nitrous acid gives an alcohol with evolution of nitrogen gas. So if it is primary amine, then primary amine with nitrous acid gives alcohol. Then the primary amine can again be investigated, can be confirmed by acetylation process. If it is primary amine, then it will react with two molecules of acetyl chloride, or you can use acetic anhydride in this case also. Then we get diacetyl derivative. If the product is diacetyl derivative, then it is primary amine. If it is again giving reacting with methyl iodide, then with three molecules of methyl iodide, then and gives quaternary salts, means two hydrogens are replaced by two CH3 groups, and then quaternization. So see carefully once again. For primary amines, reaction with nitrous acid gives alcohol. reaction with acetyl anhydride or acetyl chloride gives diacetyl derivative, and with methyl iodide, that is exhaustive methylation takes place, and this methylation leads to the formation of quaternary ammonium, that is quaternary salt. Okay, this is for primary. In case of secondary amines, reaction with nitrous acid gives nitroso compound. See the difference. Nitrous acid and primary amine gives alcohol, and nitrous acid with secondary amine gives nitroso compound. Then secondary amine with acetyl chloride gives monoacetyl. In earlier case, it gave diacetyl derivative. Diacetyl derivative formation, primary amine. Monoacetyl derivative formation, secondary amine. Then formation of alcohol, primary amine. Formation of nitroso compound, secondary amine. Now consider the last case of amines, that is tertiary amine. Tertiary amine consumes only one molecule of methyl iodide. In earlier cases, we have seen in case of primary amine, it consumes three molecules of methyl iodide. In case of tertiary amines, it consumes only one molecule of methyl iodide. Then tertiary amine with hydrogen peroxide forms amine oxide. So these are some of the reactions. The rest we will continue next time. Thank you.